just gathered here in Ibadan to look at the contributions of civil society, government, and other stakeholders, private sector, in terms of engagement and how it has affected policy, budget, and services. In Lagos, from a civil society point of view, we have been able to engage, and that has led to improved access to health, more qualitative health services in our public institutions. And we have been able to do this by civil societies conducting independent monitoring of these health institutions and giving feedback to government. In the other states, for instance, in Oyo, we know that due to engagement between government and civil society, we have been able to achieve reduction in the charges which citizens have to pay for the health insurance scheme. In the Osun State, we discovered that those who are engaged in the informal sector they were able to engage government to achieve a reduction in the taxes that government levies on them. In Ogun, for instance, we heard that the citizens were able to access more qualitative services in terms of access to power, electricity power, due to constructive engagement between the citizens and service provider and the government. So all of this show that if the atmosphere is conducive for government and CS engagement, and of course with other stakeholders in the business sector, in the informal sector, I think the people will achieve better gains in the area of budget planning, policy planning, and services.
In the area of government engagement, the state government proposed a tax of 2,500 minimum for small businesses, basic minimum for artisans in the state. So we are able to negotiate a downward review of that to 1,500 naira. Also, under the year under review, we also had entrepreneurship training for our members, supported with the support of Central Bank of Nigeria, and able to train well over 7,000 of our members in the act of effective management of our business. Basically, we also use that to leverage on encouraging members to formalize their businesses through registration with the corporate IP. And we are able to register 500 micro businesses that are not registered with the corporate IP. So these are captured and we are able to. Then most of our members that are not captured, financial inclusive, we are able to encourage them to have a bank account to transact to their businesses in line with financial regulation, which are some of the efforts that we have put in place in the And like I said, it's an ongoing thing. We continue to build on that in the coming year 2019.